The chairman of the local organizing committee for Movement for African National Initiative, MANI, Apostle Dr. Opokuina, has called on African Christians to hold on to the Lord and shun evil in order to promote and build the kingdom of God and making serving God beneficial to the rest of the world. Apostle Dr. Opokuina, who also doubles as the chairman for Ghana Evangelism Committee and Ghana Pentecostal and Charismatic Council, urged Africans to stand against Western behaviors that has the tendency to erode Africans' morals and good behavior. He made this statement at the African Heads of Churches Summit, which was held in Ghana at the Pentecost Convention Center in Komuafete near Kasua.
When Jesus was being sought to be killed, the Lord had to reveal himself to Joseph to come and hide in Africa. So you see Jesus being the Word of God hidden in Africa. So all along, Africa has been very prominent in the revelation of God. It's not only Africa. The world belongs to God, and God knows what to do at the right time. Right now, we realize that the Word of God is being destroyed in the West. Homosexuality has clearly been spelled in the Bible as not biblical, not good. God is against it. Now, if you go to the West, it has been accepted to the point that some part of Christians have also accepted it. And we realize that it is time for Africa now to hold on to this Word of God. If you come to many countries in Africa, Christianity is growing. The church in Nigeria had to combat this issue of homosexuality from the Anglican Church to the point that they did not agree. And for that matter, the entire church could not accept this issue of homosexuality. It's a sign that God has something for Africa now. If God has something for us and the Word of God is sitting here, then we need to work very hard, come together and see how we can promote Christianity, how we can promote building the kingdom of God on earth here, in order for the Word of God to be beneficial for the rest of the world. Of course, Asians too are doing very, very well, and we realize that Christianity is growing there. But we in Africa have to do our part, and this is exactly what we have come together to strategize and then promote it.
On Ghana's impending election, Dr. Opokuina cautioned Ghanaians to be wary of politicians who use tokens and monies to buy their mandate, but instead, they should scrutinize their manifestos very well and visions before voting for them.
My advice to Ghanaians is that, of course, during election year, you see some politicians, especially those who are standing for MPs and sometimes presidential candidates, sharing things to people in order to buy their mind. I think this is bad, and it's an aspect of corruption that we Ghanaians must fight against. Because if somebody says that, take this thing in order that you vote for me, it means he's taking you for granted. I mean, we should not vote for people because of what that person will give to me as an individual. We should vote for politicians because we think that their vision for the nation is so clear, so good, that it will promote the lives of the people and promote justice in the country, promote fair judgment, and promote democracy, civilization, and the welfare of the people. But if someone singles you out and say, I'm giving you a piece of cloth, maybe a machete, that's a cutlass, maybe shoe, or even computer, or any other thing, I think it's wrong. We should not allow us to be bought such way. But we should listen to the words of the politicians, listen to their vision, and vote based upon the words of the people and what we believe that those people can do for us, even parties, what you think the party can do for you.
The MANI Summit brought together African heads of churches to deliberate on the African church's response to critical issues facing Christian witnesses in Africa and the world today. The four-day summit had participating countries such as Ghana, Nigeria, Central Republic of Africa, Mauritius, Burkina Faso, Chad, Niger, Cameroon, Ethiopia, Kenya, Uganda, and more. Dr. Mario Lihin, MANI leadership team member, charged Christians to always remember their first love for the Lord and serve him truly only, for that is where they will have the desiring impact of rest for their soul.
Jesus, the head of the church, after some 40 years, a first cycle of a generation, he feels that the church is moving away from the right track. And it started with Ephesus. You have abandoned your love, your first love. And then it ends up with Laodicea knocking at the door saying, I want to come in again. And from Ephesus to Laodicea, we see the pattern, persecution in Smyrna. We see Philadelphia, the faithful church. But in between, because the Christian abandoned the first love, we see a compromising church. We see a divisive church. We see a dead church along the way. But in all these realities, at the end, the message is, he who overcomes, I will give the recompense. So we are in this situation. Let us reflect together as Jesus speaks to us, as his church in Africa, as his servants, as his elders, as his pastors, as his overseers, bishops. Let us hear what the Spirit is saying to us as we glance here and there through these snapshots this morning. It's a love relationship, the head talking to the body, the bridegroom telling the bride, what's happening? Instead of us having a more intimate relationship, you are moving away from our first love. And you and I know that is true in marriages, isn't it? The time of the first few years in married life.
The summit had several experienced men of God who shared their thoughts on an emerging critical issues that present threats and opportunities for the African churches in fulfilling the priesthood, the prophetic, and the apostolic mandate of the body of Christ in the continent and from the continent to the rest of the world in the 21st century and beyond if Christ tarries. Bishop Edmond Akanya of Nigeria admonishes African Christian leaders to model for people to see the lifestyle of Jesus Christ by equipping their church members with the word of God and build the church to be the desirable body of Christ that they deserve. He added that our Christian leaders in Africa who are feeding on their congregation must stop, but instead promote evangelism and mission in Africa to save their soul for Christ.
So there are shepherds who are leading people astray. There are shepherds who are teaching people what God has not said. But thank God that we have an example in the person of the great good shepherd. The example laid down for us by Jesus Christ himself, who laid down his life for the flock. He showed that example to us in John chapter 10. John chapter 10 from verse 10 to 13, that Jesus Christ laid down his life. He became an example, became a shepherd that laid down his life for the sheep. He showed that very clearly in the way he lived. When he washed the disciples' feet, Jesus Christ showed an example of what it means to be a leader, what it means to go before the people, what it means to show the people how to follow. And this is what the Lord is calling us into as we live out our lives, as we reflect the glory and the person of Jesus Christ as heads of churches in Africa. We must model for people to see the lifestyle of Jesus Christ, that he left an example for us, the Bible says, that we should follow in his steps. These are the examples that Jesus Christ left for us that he wants us to demonstrate. So, where is your emphasis? What are you teaching those who are following you?
On his closing remarks, the chairman of the local organizing committee, Apostle Dr. Opokunina, had this to say.
Brothers and sisters in the Lord, We want to give thanks to the Almighty God once again for giving us the opportunity to host this important summit in Ghana. When I was asked to give the closing remark, I said that everything now can be ended with the continental leadership. But the leadership said that at least I should come and bring you something. So we thank the Almighty God that in the final analysis, this summit has taken place. It has taken us a long time from Abuja 2011 to Ghana 2016. And I know that the Lord has dealt with us from various angles for having the opportunity to lead a devotion as I went through the two chapters of Revelation. I realized that the Lord has spoken to us through the letter to the seven churches. For instance, in Ephesians, we realized that Ephesians was a very hard working and a busy church. However, the members there could persevere and endure. Their doctrine was sound, for they could not tolerate false doctrines, but they had left their first love. Therefore, the lesson we draw from Ephesians is that sometimes we can become so concerned about programs, works, plans, and targets that the Holy Spirit may be forgotten in our day-to-day activities. We can become so busy hunting for a wrong way of doing things and identifying false doctrines that love can dry up and die out of us. A doing church can be a sign of backsliding church, and perhaps more doing leads to backsliding. Therefore, through the devotion and through Ephesians, our mind have been drawn to the need to love one another, and that African church should also consider the churches that are suffering and extend our love to them. Smyrna was going through persecution. They were being afflicted and slandered. They were poor. Some of them even faced death. Yet, it was one of the churches that did not attract any condemnation. Smyrna shows us that affliction, poverty, and suffering do not mean that the Christian is under a curse. And as such, Africa is under a curse. Nor do they mean that the Christian is being disciplined by the Lord. They may at times be the evidence that the Spirit of God is very active in a church or a person's life. Therefore, once persecution is going on, Christians must come together. We must find the critical needs of the persecuted churches in order for us to minister to their needs. In Pergamum, the church remained true to the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. They could go through persecution without denying the name of Christ. Yet, some of them held on to the teaching of Nicolaitans and Balaam. The fault of the leaders was that they had demonstrated an indiscriminate tolerance, which ultimately misled many to sin. The implication for the church in Africa is that failure to watch and guide the flock, their food and their interests may lead them to compromise, which will eventually lead many to destruction. So, taking into consideration the sort of ministration that is going on in the continent, we need to promote the Word of God in order for the Word of God to become supreme in whatever we are doing. Now, Thyatira was doing more good deeds than they had done before. There were more doings than talking, more implementations than decisions. However, they allowed the false prophetess to operate without correcting her. This created in many the desire to know the so-called deep secret of Satan and also misled many into worldliness. Thyatira symbolizes those who claim more knowledge and power other than the revealed revelation in the Bible. Again, it shows the position of leadership of a church that fails to execute their responsibility in the name of love. And therefore, out of love, you should be able to stamp out whatever we need to stamp out, even within the church, as we keep on talking about corruption. We need to use the church as an example of an institution where there is no corruption. And Sardis was a church that lived in its past glory. It had the reputation that it was alive, but it was dead. So with the little resources we have in Africa here, we can still help to keep the message of Christ here and promote it. Because once we begin to promote it, the Lord will bless the little effort that we put in. And again, Laodicea Church was wealthy, proud, and the only church with no condemnation from the Lord. The church's main problem was that the people were lukewarm, neither cold nor hot. This is to say that they were neither providing refreshment for the spiritual weary nor healing for those people who were worried and sick. The church today has the futures of the churches that show that the feelings of indifference and unconcernedness to either doctrinal teachings or the demonstration of power. In other words, we must begin to have concern for one another and begin to see that we need Christ at all levels and allow him to take over. So taking the devotions into consideration, we realize that these were the stays of the churches there. And what should we do as the church in Africa? For instance, in Ephesus, there was more doing than love, while in Pergamon, there was more love than doing. Both are not good. What we need to do as leaders is to strike a balance between the word and the spirit, discipline and love, the teaching of doctrine and the demonstration of the Holy Spirit's power. The two go together. So as we have examined critical issues in facing the church, especially in Africa and the world, it is our prayer that as we go, we will continue to draw lessons from the letters to the seven churches and apply ourselves to whatever comes out from our community in order for us to be the voices of the Lord on earth here, prophetic voice of Africa, and also for us to be vessels of honor that the Lord can use to communicate his message to contemporary world. May the Lord God Almighty continue to bless his church in Africa and the rest of the world. God bless you.
At the end of the summit, the Africa Heads of Churches issued a communique. Several men and women of the people who participated at the summit spoke to Pen TV.
I am Dr. Mrs. Obed. My husband and I pastored our church for 21 years in Nigeria before we handed it over to another person. Currently, my husband and I are doing discipleship. We are coordinators of Apostolic Discipleship Movement in Nigeria.
I'm Reverend Dr. Steve Asante, the immediate past president of the Ghana Baptist Convention and also a former director of the Ghana Evangelism Committee. And currently, I pastor Asoka Baptist Church in Kumasi. But I'm all over the world doing missions for the Lord.
Thank you very much. But why is it important for Christian leaders to meet and have a summit?
It is so important, so crucial and timely because of all that is going on. We know false prophetism going on, persecution, the rise of extremism in different religions, and also a very perceived and yet rightly observation of the fact that the church itself has lost some steam. So we have come as leaders to refocus, to trust the Lord for a revival, for us to be on course for the cause of Christ. Society will see transformation, integrity will be in place, and we will see all the corruption going on challenged with biblical values.
My name is Reverend Dr. Emmanuel Zigao from Nigeria. I came purposely for this summit.
All right. So now, by the grace of God, the program has ended. What is your general assessment of this summit?
Well, very, very well, because my general assessment of this program, the kind of the leadership, church leaders that came from all over the country, And I saw that there is a need for this such meeting. And then since we have met, things are going to change very well in our continent concerning the church and even entire continent.
What one message that caught your heart that you are sending to your country to work with?
My country that in a very difficult time, Nigeria, particularly in the northern Nigeria, I send this message, particularly the leaders of churches, to meet with our resolution here that we are going to fight to stand firm, defend our faith. Africa as a large, we are having problem here and there, so we have to unite ourselves and defend our faith in order to church will move in this continent.
Thank you very much.
Well, Reverend Clement from Chad, I work as a mission director, you know, in a mission resource center. And so I'm glad with the meeting particularly focus more on the life and the inner life of the church leader in Africa today. And we wrestle with issues. And so I'm glad that, you know, we were challenged, particularly looking at, you know, Revelation 2 and 3, and looking at, you know, the problems the church is struggling with from outside within. And so I'm going back with an encouragement from the Lord to, first of all, be a worshiper, not just, you know, a worker, but at the same time also the challenge of helping the church to grow in a qualitative way. The challenge to teach the members, the challenge to do an intentional discipleship, the challenge to walk towards revival.
My name's Reverend Dr. Soja Biwarang, from Nigeria, the chairman of Christian Association. This is one of the summits that is very, very enriching. Anything that begins and ends well is glorifying to the name of the Lord. This summit took care of the good things and challenged the church in the area that we will move forward.
My name is Nosa Tukura. I'm from Nigeria. I serve on the continental leadership team of the Movement for African National Initiatives. And I'm really excited that this summit has finally come and has ended. And what particularly makes me excited is the fact that a major outcome in the planning and preparation for this summit was to get African church leaders to sit and reflect and discuss critical issues that affect the church in Africa, fulfilling our global mission to take the gospel not only to the unreached within Africa, but also without. And the last 2 days, today being the third day, we've spent deliberating on these key issues. And I'm really excited at the responses we're getting from these leaders, that they are taking this back to their home countries and they are fired up, they are passionate about, you know, the church becoming again the church of the Lord Jesus Christ and fulfilling his mission on earth.